your coffee table and stop chewing it on the floor.
Yeah.
I said, leave it. And she went, and she left it. And for the next hour, she did not throw back at all. You look behind the door.
Oh, that's funny.
I've got a baby gate. Now, I've just put that up. I put a bed down here, which is not near anywhere to chew. Because it's important that they have somewhere soft to lie on, but not near a stair corner or anywhere where they can lie and chew.
Now that Victoria has confirmed Cashmere's chewing becomes important, she wants to exercise.
Cuddles. Cuddles, what do you say? You want to get out of the desk and fluff your tail? You want to get out of your desk and fluff the tail? Come on, Cuddles, get under there. Go on. Get under the desk and fluff the tail. Come on, fluff it. Cuddles. Cuddles. Cuddles.
Now that we just have a little bit of insight into Cashmere's garden behavior, let's do that. Cashmere only gets to go to sandbox when she's out there by herself. And then, our grandson can come out and he can use the sandbox by himself too. So, obviously, I want you to take the dogs outside as much as possible, and I want you to play with them in the yard.
Cuddles, watch TV.
Cashmere's controlling behavior towards Barnsley convinces Victoria.